Good afternoon to all the students of class 5. Students, today again we are going to continue with the topic decimal fraction. Today we are going to do addition of decimals. Now before coming into the sums, we would like to learn a few rules of addition of decimals. Now here are the few rules of addition of decimals. The first rule is that write the digits of the given numbers one below the other such that all the decimal points are in the same vertical line. So here you will have to write all the digits one below the other. You will have to arrange in that way so that all the decimal points come in the same alignment. Next is add as we add whole numbers. The method of addition is going to remain same as the addition of whole numbers. Next is put the decimal point of the sum, that means the additional value which you are getting, vertically just below the other decimal points. So as you can see over here, an example is given. So here three decimal numbers has been added. All the numbers has been placed one below the other in such a way that you keep the decimal point in the same straight vertical line. Alright, and in the answer line also, you keep the decimal point in the same alignment. Alright, and the method of addition is going to remain the same. Now see over here, you have to add 22.3 plus 34.1. Now children, look over here. You will have to write the numbers in such a way that all the decimal points are one below the other. And after that, carry on with the addition in the same way as you do the addition of whole numbers. Here, always we start from the right side. 3 plus 1. That is, we are getting 4. Then after that, you find the decimal point over here. See, here the decimal point has been lined up. So below the decimal points, you will have to write the decimal point keeping the same alignment. And after that, you add 2 plus 4, that is 6, and 3 plus 2, that is 5. So you are getting the answer as 56.4. All right. Now let's see the next sum. 1.234 plus 4.1. Now children, here we see the integer part. Just look at the integer part. In the first case, the integer is 1, and the next case, the integer is 4. So here, you will always keep in mind that the method of addition will remain same. So you are writing 4 over here. Why 4 you are writing? Because here you have 4.1. And after 1, nothing is there means we can consider the two zeros are here. Alright, as I have told you before also that in the last place of the decimal part, we can put as many number of zeros as we want. So here you are adding 4 plus 0, that is 4. 3 plus 0, that is 3. 2 plus 1, that is 3. Then 4 plus 1, which is 5. Now you can see the decimal point arranged over here. You can see that the points are one below the other. So you will write the point over here also, just below all the points. Alright. Now here we have the few examples showing addition of decimals consisting of three decimal numbers. So here at first, in order to bring all the digits, all the number of digits same after the decimal point, we can introduce a zero over here. As you can see, in the first case you have 0.32 and in the next case you have 12.965, then you have 1.1. So here you can see the highest number of digits in the decimal part is 3. Alright, the highest number of digits. So you will have to make all the other decimal numbers also up to 3 digits in the decimal part. So in the first case it is 0.32, so you introduce another 0 in order to make it up to 3 digit. Next you have 12.965, next you have 1.1. so after 1.1, after this one you can introduce 2 more zeros in order to make the decimal part up to 3 digits. Then after that, what you will do is you are going to carry on the addition as you do the addition of whole numbers. As you can see over here, that 0 plus 5 plus 0, which is 5. Next, 2 plus 6 plus 0, which is 8. Then 3 plus 9 plus 1, which is 13. And you have carry 1. So now you add 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 4. Then after that you write 1 over here and you are getting 14.385 as the answer. So in this way you are adding the 3 decimal numbers. You will have to first look at the decimal number which is having the highest number of digits in the decimal part. Then after that you make the remaining numbers, the remaining decimal numbers also equivalent or equal to that number of digits in the decimal part. In the next example you can see 51 plus 14.02 plus 2.1. So here what we will do, this 51 is a whole number, alright? So you will have to change the whole number to decimal number. How you can change it? You can introduce a decimal point, then after that put 2 zeros after the decimal point. As you know children, that putting zeros after the decimal point in the last place has got no value. So you are writing 51.00. Next you have 14.02. So you are writing 14.02. Next you have 2.1. So you are writing 2.10. Why? Because you will have to make the digits in the decimal place up to two digits. You will have to make the digits in the decimal part up to 2 digits. So now you start adding up 0 plus 2 plus 0, that is 2. Then 0 plus 0 plus 1, that is 1. Next 4 plus 1 plus 2, that is 7. Then 5 plus 1, that is 6. So you are getting 67.12 as the answer. So here you can see a step by step procedure has been shown for the addition of decimals. At first you will have to line up the decimal points, then pad with zeros. That means you will have to introduce extra zeros in order to bring it up to the highest number of digits that is present in the decimal part. Next you will have to continue with the addition as you do the addition of whole numbers. Here we have another sum, 3.21 plus 4.5. So children, in 3.21 you have 2 digits in the decimal part, and in 4.5 you have only 1 digit after the decimal part, 1 digit in the decimal part. So what you will do, you will have to introduce a 0 over here and then line up the decimal points. As you can see, the decimal point has been put over here. Then start adding 1 plus 0, that is 0, 2 plus 5, that is 7, and 3 plus 4, which is 7. So you are getting 7.71. All right. Next you have 1.452 plus 1.3. So in the first case the decimal points has been lined up. Next you can see in 1.452 after 1 you have the numbers in the decimal part up to 3 digits. So in the next step, what we will do is we are going to write 1.452, then in the next decimal number 1.3, you are going to introduce these two extra zeros in order to make it up to 3 digits in the decimal part. Then after that, start adding 2 plus 0, that is 2, 5 plus 0, that is 5, 4 plus 3, that is 7, and 1 plus 1, that is 2. So you are getting the answer as 2.752. Now let's work out a few sums of your maths textbook. Here we will have to add the given decimal numbers. First one, 12.67 and 4.34. So you are writing 12.67 plus 4.34. So here, while writing the integer part, keep in mind about writing the digits in its appropriate place values, okay, in its correct place. So 12.67 plus 4.34, you are writing the decimal points one below the other, then after that carrying on the addition as you do. I hope by this time you have understood that how to add 7 plus 4, that is 11, then you have carry 1. That means you are adding now 6 plus 3, that is 9 plus 1, which is 10. You are writing the 0. Then after that, again carry 1 over here. Now again 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 4, that is 7. Now this 1 plus here, nothing is there, means 0, which is 0. So you are getting the answer as 17.01. Next, 425.93 plus 85.65 plus 12.96. Here also, children, you will have to first write all the numbers in its correct place. Here we find that all the three numbers have two digits after the decimal point. That means in its decimal part, all the three decimal numbers have two digits. So here we need not introduce any extra zeros, just like part A. Here also we are going to write all the numbers one below the other, then after that start adding as we add the whole numbers. Alright, then after adding we are getting 524.54. Now next one, here we have to add 4 decimal numbers. Now children, method will remain the same, whether it is 4 decimal number or it is 5 decimal number or any number of decimal numbers you will be given to add. The process is going to remain the same. As you can see over here, at first all the numbers has been written in such a way that you keep the decimal point one below the other in a single alignment, then after that do the addition as you add the whole numbers. Alright. Next one, you find that the decimal numbers does not have same number of digits in the decimal part. As in case you see that over here you find 175.8. So as I have told you, you will have to look at the highest number of digits present in the decimal part. So here you have 350.358. So that means in this case, in the third decimal number, the number of digits in the decimal part is highest. So we will have to introduce extra zeros in the decimal part in order to make it up to three decimal numbers. In order to make it up to three digits in the decimal part. So here I am writing 175.8, introducing two zeros. It was only 8. So now in order to make it up to 3 decimal digit, I am introducing 2 more zeros. Now in the next you have 200.03. So here another zero has been introduced. Next, 412.358. This will remain as it is. Next is 18.9. So here 18.9 you will write. Then after that introduce two more zeros. Alright children, first write down the numbers. Then after that introduce the zeros. First write down the numbers in such a way that all the decimal points lie in a single line. Then after that you are adding as you add the numbers. Here 0 plus 0 plus 8 plus 0, which is 8. And after that 0 plus 3 plus 5 plus 0, which is 8. Then after that 8 plus 0 plus 3 plus 9, which is equals to 20. So you're writing the 0 of 20 and carry 2. So now you add 2 plus 5, that is 7. 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 8, 17. 7, then again carry 1. 7 plus 1, 8. 9, 10. 10, 0, carry 1. And after that 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 4, that is 8. So you are getting the final answer as 807.088. Alright. Next sum is a what problem type sum? The question is, a tailor needs 52.18 centimeter of white lace for Richa's skirt and 75.85 centimeter of the same lace for the top. How much lace does he need all? So in total you will have to add the two lengths. At first you are going to write in the solution length of white lace for Richa's skirt, which is equals to 52.18. next is length of white lace for his top, that is equals to 75.85. then the total length you are going to add and you will get the answer in centimeters. Now this one also addition has been done in the same process. You can see two digits are present after the decimal point in both the cases, in case of both the numbers. Now you are simply adding 8 plus 5, that is 13, carry 1. Then you have 8 plus 1 plus 1, which is 10. Then after that carry 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 5, that is 8. Then you have 7 plus 5, which is 12. So 128.03 centimeter is the answer. So you are writing, a tailor needs 128.03 centimeter white lace. Next sum is, find the perimeter of the adjoining figure. So here you can see the figure is given. Now perimeter means the sum of all its sides, the sum of the length of all the sides. So here the length of all the sides has been given. So the perimeter of the figure will be, just you will have to add all the numbers. So here you will have to add how many decimal numbers? Here you will have to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 decimal numbers you will have to add. You are going to line up all the decimal points, then do the addition as you do the addition of whole numbers. So you are getting the value as 33.19 centimeter. So this is the perimeter of the figure is 33.19 centimeter. I hope children you understood how to do the addition. You are going to write it like this: 4.7, then 5.86, then after that 2.6, then after that 4.2, now 1.20, then again 1.20, then after that you will have 13.43. So I'm writing this on the top, 13.43. All right. Then after that, you do the addition. You will have to bring the zeros, extra zeros you will have to introduce in order to make it up to 2 decimal place. Then after that, do the addition as you do. All right, children. So your answer will be, the perimeter of the figure is 33.19 centimeter. So you are going to copy down the entire content in your maths notebook. So thank you, children, for today.